understand today that God's for you and He's not against you. Amen. He's on your side today. And He's not sitting up there to hurt you. He's just wanting to lift you back up. Amen. Leviticus 6, start at verse 8 with me, if you will. Stand for the reading of God's Word. We're going to read verses 8 through 13. And the Lord spoke unto Moses, saying, now notice who spoke. The Lord. Look at your neighbor and say, I got to listen. Now, don't listen to the preacher. Listen to the Lord. Command Aaron and his son, saying, this is the law of the burnt offering. It is the burnt offering because of the burning upon the altar all night until the morning. And the fire of the altar shall be burning in it. The priest shall put on his linen garment, his linen breeches shall he put upon his flesh, and take up the ashes which fire hath consumed with the burnt offering on the altar, and he shall put them aside beside the altar. And he shall put off his garments, and put on other garments, and carry forth the ashes without the camp unto a clean place. And the fire upon the altar shall be burning in it. It shall not be put out. And the priest shall burn wood on it every morning, and lay the burnt offering in order upon it, and he shall burn thereon the fat of the peace offering. Verse 13, the fire shall ever be burning upon the altar. It shall never go out. Amen. I want you to notice a couple verses here, especially 10 and 13. I'm going to read one more here, but notice where God told Moses, take up the ashes of your offering, which the fire has consumed. Verse 13, where God tells us the fire shall ever burn upon this altar, and it shall never go out. Now look at one more with me, if you will, in Numbers 4. Numbers chapter 4. I'm going to look there, and I'm going to pray, and we're going to be seated and going to the message of the hour. Verse 13. Look at the Numbers 4. Verse 13. Say amen when you found it. Amen. Now listen to this, church. And they shall take away the ashes from the altar and spread a purple cloth thereon. Brother Joe, would you pray?
Father, we thank you for this word.
Yes, we do.
We ask you, Lord, that you touch and anoint our pastor, Lord, afresh. Stir within him, Lord, Father, Holy Ghost, coal of fire. Father, touch the congregation that we receive this acceptable word, Lord, Father. And God, that we pray, Lord, that we put it to use in our lives.
Amen.
God, that we'll be ever careful to give you praise, glory, and honor. In the name of Jesus.
Amen. You may be seated. Thank God today that the Lord can still speak to us, church. If you're saved today, He said, my sheep know His voice, and another they will not follow, they will not listen. Thank God today that He can still speak, and we can hear His voice. The Bible said that it was the Lord that spoke to Moses. Listen to me, church. It was the Lord. It wasn't the preacher that spoke to him. It wasn't the Sunday school teacher or the evangelist that spoke to him. It wasn't the baseball coach or the CEO or any man that spoke to Moses. The Bible said it was God Himself that spoke to Moses, and God told him, said, it's time to clean up the ashes off the altar. Amen. It's time to take away the ashes from the altar. I want to speak to you on this subject this morning if I can. And anyone who knows anything about burning wood, how many have ever burnt wood, maybe to heat fire, in this story, this message ought to go over well today, because anybody that knows anything about burning wood is going to know what I'm talking about this morning. Because when you put a fresh piece of wood in that fireplace and there's no ashes there, everything's clean. It's like you come to Christ and He cleans everything out. You put that fresh piece of fire in that fireplace, you light it up, and it begins to burn hot, and it begins to burn high. And when you put that fresh piece of wood in that fireplace, and offer it, don't matter if the lights are off or how dark it is in the house, once you get that thing in there and it starts to burn, it'll still give you enough light so you can see where it is that you're going in the house. Anyone that knows about burning wood will also know that if you leave that wood on there and keep piling more on top of it, and piling more on top of it, and you never get up, and I never get up, and we go over and take out those ashes, if we leave those ashes in there, it will eventually Say, I got to listen to something this morning. Amen. I got to remove some ashes from the altar this morning. The Lord told Moses, said, the fire on this altar shall burn continually. It shall never, ever go out. Come on, church. He said, it's the place where my people come and they make their petitions known. It's the place where my people cry out in the early morning hours. Somebody knows what I'm talking about this morning. It's the place that I go when my children are acting up. It's the place that I go when the bills seem to overcome me. It's the place that I go when I'm down in spirit. And I go before the Lord into that altar in the early morning hours. And I cry out to God and make known my petitions. It's the place where they sacrifice. We sacrifice our praise and our prayers. And we sacrifice our most intimate thoughts to God. The Lord said, tell my people Moses, when they cried out in those early morning hours, when they made the request known, when they made an end of their petitions, tell them, I've heard their cry. I've heard their cry. Tell them it's time to change. We just hit a place to stop there. Bible said that God told Moses that you tell Aaron his sons. How many of you know who Aaron and his sons represent? It represents the priesthood of God. You say, well, boy, I'm glad, preacher. I thought you had me over a barrel there. I thought I was going to have to do something. Amen. Revelation 5, verse 10 says, we've been saved through the blood of Jesus Christ, and He's made us also kings and priests. Amen. So there are some things that we have to do also today. Amen. Tell my people when they cry out in the early morning hours, tell them to change their garment, change their thoughts, and know that I'm God, and I'll remove the ashes, amen, of yesterday. Remove the offerings. And God said, so I can be able to come in and the fire of God can begin to burn. Listen, I've had some stuff built up in me. I've had some stuff, church, that just fell on my altar. Some ashes that just left, or I left, just laying around. And I found out, as long as I left them there, it did nothing but cause me harm. It hindered my walk with God. It kept me from receiving the joy of the Lord. It kept me from being able to praise God the way I need to praise God. God said, if you need some joy back, if you need some hope back, you've got some ashes that have fell around the altar of your heart, and it's time to remove some of those ashes. Come on, church. Somebody here besides me needs this. There's some ashes that have piled up. Ashes of resentment. Ashes of contempt. Ashes of unforgiveness. Maybe even ashes of hatred. Amen. Amen. Those ashes fall within the altar of our heart. And the fire of God tries to burn through so that we can reach out and He can reach down and He can pick us up. But it's caused that flame to begin to dwindle down. You know what I'm talking about? It's called that fire to begin to go out. Amen. You're sitting here today and you're saying, I don't see it, preacher. You may not, but I pray to God today that you'll see it before it's eternally too late. I pray to God today that you'll understand that sometimes the ashes of this world, sometimes the ashes of our own flesh will fall upon the altar of our heart. And before you know it, it don't take long. It can be overnight. I went to bed before with that fire burning bright, amen. That thing just burning and heating the house. And I got up in the morning hours and that thing would be go out. And it's cold as ice. Hey, it don't take long. Overnight the enemy, he can mess with you. Amen. Overnight the flesh can take you down. And before you know it, the fire of God upon the altar of your heart has went out. Amen. hadn't even realized it. Come on, church. Come on. Somebody, grab hold. You're wanting a fresh anointing. You're looking for a healing. Looking for a deliverance. You're looking for a new thing from God. But the fire on the altar has accumulated so many ashes in your life, in your heart, that it's began to smother out the fire of God. You're still wondering if God's still going to answer that prayer. You're still wondering if the healing's going to come. I know you're still hurting. I know some pain is still there. But we're not supposed to wonder if God is able. We're supposed to know that God can do what He says He can do. God said you've made your offerings. You've come and you've made your petitions known before me. Let it go. Clean up the ashes of yesterday's offerings and let the fire of God begin to move. Know that when I speak to the storm will obey. The storm will cease. You gotta know that when my spiritual eyes are blinded, God said I can reach out and I can open those eyes. Amen. You got to know when sickness and disease threatens your body, your attitude, your garment has got to change. I can't walk around saying, oh, gloom and doom. I can't walk around saying, oh, I hurt so bad. I can't walk around and tell people all the aches and the pains. But God said, out of the word of your mouth comes life and death. Speak those things that will give you life. Amen. Know that God is able. A lot of us, come on, church. A lot of us confess that we believe God is able. But you still tied up in yesterday's offering. You still wrapped up in yesterday's offering. Come on, church. We got to let that go. We've done asked God.
Yes, sir.
We've done told God what we needed. Now, our part comes. Now I've got to believe and know. There's a difference. Faith, there's a difference, church. Saying I believe and knowing that you know is two totally different things. When you can lay down at night and you know the wolf's knocking on the door and you say, God, I don't know what I'm going to do, but I know that you're going to take care of me. And when you can lay down and go to sleep and say, I ain't got no part of it, it's in God's hand, then you can say, I trust God. I know that He's able. We got to get the doubt out, change the garments, change our attitudes, change our thoughts, and we got to know that God is God and there's none other. He's the Almighty today. He's my Father. I'm His child. You're His child. He'll take care of us. He says, I need you to believe in what I'm doing. He said, when I spoke, the world came into existence. When I breathed, just the breath of my nostrils, I split open the Red Sea. There's people in here, amen, they don't know which way they're going to go tomorrow. They don't know which way to turn. And God said, take note, all I got to do is just one breath of my nostril, and I can open a path, amen, that will lead you to dry ground. Come on, church. You got to know. There's some ashes that needs to be removed. Huh? You got to know that there's nothing impossible with God. Nothing. You got to know, amen, that your God is able to meet that need. God said, I am that I am, and I still am. I am that I am, and I still ain't nobody dethroned me yet. Ain't nobody took me out of the portals of heaven. Ain't nobody done come and took my throne. I still say what goes on. I'm still God. And if you're my child, if you listen, if you'll obey, if you'll apply those things that I give you, I will make sure that everywhere your foot steps, you will prosper. the great I am. And he's still the great I am. He's not the I was. Amen. Church, it's time to clean the ashes of doubt and let the fire of God begin to consume and to burn in the altar of our heart again. Again. Amen. God loves us today. And I don't know about you. I can't speak for you. All I can speak for is me. And I learned something. I learned that I had so much stuff. So many ashes piled up around the heart, around the altar of my heart, that I've done lost the joy of the Lord. You can come to church and put a smile on. That don't mean you've got the joy of the Lord in your heart. You can come on and put that mask on. That don't mean you've got the joy of the Lord. And I know. I've done it. I know. Amen. So much piled upon the altar of my heart that the fire of God was just barely beginning to burn. Amen. But I think it was Paul that said, you need to take it. You need to stir up. Stir up that gift that God put in you. You ever been camping? Been out there in wee order early mornings, and that campfire go out, and you go out and just take a stick, stir that thing up, before long that flame begin to jump back. Some of you need to stir up that gift that God has put in you. Some of us need to know that there's some ashes that have fell around the altar of our heart. We can say, well, I'm all right and everything's okay. Amen. But I'm telling you, when you're on fire for God, amen, God says people are going to know that you're on fire for Him. Amen. Jeremiah says, I wanted to quit. I wanted to stop preaching God's word. I was tired of being ridiculed. I was tired of people talking about me. I preached for God for years. Nobody paid me no attention. I got so mad that I told God I ain't preaching no more. But Jeremiah said, I tried it and I couldn't do it because there was a fire that was shut up in me that I could not put out. Come on, church. Come on. God said that fire is supposed to burn continually. You and I are not supposed to let that fire go out. We're not allowed by God, a direct command of God, to let that fire go out. He said, that thing's got to ever be burning. You know why? Because if you get discouraged, if you get down, if you allow the devil to put doubt in your mind, you'll go today and you'll say, well, I'm praying today. Ain't doing no good to pray. I ain't going to pray. You'll go another day, I ain't going to pray today. Next thing you know, you've been 2-3 weeks